Being a pro wrestler is a lot of hard work. You spend countless hours in a ring, training and hoping to perfect your craft, all while developing a look and character that can help set you apart from the rest of the crowd. Even if you're great in the ring, have a fantastic character, and have great look to boot, there's no guarantee that you will make it in the business. Of the few who do make it, they have to work tirelessly to stay at the top of their game because one badly timed injury can throw you off the top of the mountain. Despite all the blood, sweat, and tears, pro wrestlers still aren't recognized as conventional celebrities, and that is a massive shame. Actors, singers, and sportsmen will always be held in higher regard than pro wrestlers because being a wrestler means that everything you do caters to a relatively niche crowd. While this is a gross injustice, there have been numerous times in the past where that line has been blurred. A bunch of WWE stars can show up on SNL out of nowhere, and people like The Rock or John Cena can use their fame as a wrestler to launch a pretty successful Hollywood endeavor. The other most common way wrestlers get thrusted into the mainstream eye is when they are romantically linked to celebrities. Tabloids and gossip blogs go wild every time a popular star is seen with a pro wrestler, and even if it has become relatively normalized now, it's still a big deal. So let's check out 10 times celebrities dated wrestlers. Jeremy Piven is a pretty good actor and was definitely the highlight of the popular TV show Entourage, but he also holds the distinction of being one of the worst guest hosts on WWE programming ever. There are very few celebrities who have actually managed to have a good showing in WWE, so the bar has never really been that high. Somehow, Piven managed to hit a new low during his stint as guest host in 2009, and it was obvious that Piven had absolutely no idea about WWE and that he was probably just there to pick up a paycheck. His biggest flub was calling SummerSlam Summerfest. And even the comedic tactics of Ken Jeong couldn't do much to salvage an absolute train wreck of a show. Soon after his episode on Raw, on an online blog, Jim Ross stated that Piven spent pretty much all of his time backstage trying to get the contact information of the female talent. He obviously succeeded in getting at least one number, as Piven and Kelly Kelly were pictured getting cozy at a New York Jets game. The relationship never turned serious though, as it was reported that the two went their separate ways just a few months after they spent time together. Alex Rodriguez will probably go down as one of the most controversial athletes in Major League Baseball history, and it's pretty easy to see why. Rodriguez, or A-Rod, got into hot water on multiple occasions for steroid use in an industry that was staunchly against it. His massive wages, though, were more than enough to offset the numerous suspensions he faced over the course of his career. While he was considered a bad boy of the sport, Rodriguez always kept an eye turned towards the future. He created and developed his own business and has become a pretty successful entrepreneur, even showing up as one of the sharks on Shark Tank every now and then. It's clear that Rodriguez always had his eye out for ventures outside baseball. So it should come as no surprise to anyone that A-Rod had a long-term relationship with former WWE star Torrie Wilson from 2011 to 2015. Wilson is widely considered to be one of the most attractive women to ever set foot in a WWE ring, and with two stints as the Playboy cover girl, it's pretty hard to dispute that. The two had a pretty strong relationship as they made it through numerous allegations, but they had to call the quits in early 2015 and George Clooney is considered to be one of the most attractive men in Hollywood. There are millions of people around the world who would love to get the chance to be with Mr. Clooney, but there are only a few who can say they have. Before finding his way to the absolutely wonderful Amal Clooney, he made waves, or maybe in this case tsunamis, in the press when he was linked to the stunning Stacy Keibler. Fans of WWE remember Keibler very fondly, even after a decade away from the company, and a lot of them must have hoped that her relationship with Clooney would last. But, of course, it didn't. The two had a good run, though. They began dating sometime in 2011, but it came to an end in 2013, which, according to reports, was not surprising to anyone close to Keibler or Clooney. While they are unlikely to ever become the best of friends, they both did find love and are now happily married. WWE's poor treatment of Gail Kim robbed the universe of one of the greatest female performers of all time. Kim has every reason to be mad at the company, and she has made it clear that she hasn't forgiven Vince and the company. Even if she doesn't look back at her time with WWE too fondly, she does have to thank the company for one thing: it brought her future husband. The 7-time TNA Knockouts champion is married to celebrity chef Robert Irvine. Irvine served in the British Royal Navy, and it has been reported that his time in the military makes him notoriously difficult to work with. He's obviously a different man behind closed doors, as he hit it off with Kim pretty much instantly after the pair met when a part of his show was filmed at SummerSlam. It's been reported that the two began dating almost immediately and got married a few years later. The two remain happily married even today after tying the knot in 2012. This could be seen as a bit of a cop-out, but for all intents and purposes, David Arquette can be considered a wrestler because he did win the WCW title, a feat a number of true pro wrestlers can't even claim. He got married to Friends star Courtney Cox back in 99. If you were a fan of the series, you might remember an episode of the show where all the cast members had Arquette added to their last names to celebrate the marriage. The couple had their first child a year after the show ended, but they ended up getting divorced 9 years later in 2013 after 14 years spent together. But unlike so many other broken marriages, Cox and Arquette are believed to have remained friends and both have found love away from each other. Most people today probably would not remember who Rhonda Scheer is, but she was Miss USA in 1975. She made a name for herself as a TV personality and is known for her work in a show called Up All Night. Back when he was still a bad boy, Shawn Michaels made an appearance on the show, and Scheer, in turn, appeared as a ring announcer at WrestleMania 10. In keeping with Michaels' playboy lifestyle at the time, it was strongly rumored that the two were romantically involved. Paige has faced her fair share of controversy over the course of her career, in addition to dealing with a number of relationships during that time. One of these relationships took center stage in Total Divas, as the show focused a fair amount on the ups and downs of her status with the guitarist from A Day to Remember, Kevin Scaff. The two seemed pretty happy together, and they were even engaged for a short while before eventually breaking up. Paige experienced something similar a little while after, as her controversial partnership with fellow wrestler Alberto Del Rio also ended after the two were engaged. David Otunga hasn't wrestled in ages, and that might be for the better. Even though his career as a wrestler never took off, he always remained in the public eye as he was married to singer and actor Jennifer Hudson. The two tied the knot 7 months into their relationship in 2008, but the relationship ended in divorce in 2017. The two remained pretty civil during the entire ordeal, and there has not been any reference to the ending of the 2-time tag team champion's marriage on WWE programming, which, let's be honest, is a little surprising because that is exactly the kind of story WWE would love to milk for all it's worth. Kelly Kelly makes her second entry on this list, and unfortunately this relationship doesn't have a happy ending either. Kelly Kelly was reported to have a penchant for dating a number of celebrities, and that narrative was carried forward when she began dating Sheldon Surrey, a National Hockey League player. The two met in 2011 before getting married in February of 2016. Unfortunately, that was when the relationship began to unravel, as the two ended up getting separated the very next year. Surrey has had a pretty illustrious career as a hockey player, and even if Kelly wasn't the most gifted or decorated superstar in the WWE, she is fondly remembered by the fans and even made an appearance at the inaugural Women's Royal Rumble match last year. Kelly has followed in the footsteps of Total Divas and Total Bellas and appears in a reality TV show called WAGS on the E! Network. A lot has been said about Amy Schumer's brand of humor, but there is no denying that she is one of the biggest comedians in the States right now. Dolph Ziggler is also trying to build a career as a comedian for himself outside WWE, so it's no surprise that the two dated each other. Schumer, who has never shied away from sharing, stated that she started dating Dolph soon after a breakup with her longtime boyfriend, and when the latter wanted to get back together, she dumped Dolph and did. It was pretty rough for Ziggles, but the two have managed to remain friends, so all is well. And these were 10 times celebrities dated pro wrestlers. I hope you're all having an amazing day. Thank you so much for watching Wrestling Hub, and I will see you later with more videos.